Chapter 23, The Present State of Radio in the UK. As we come to the end of this story of Radio 1, I thought it worthwhile to look at the state of all popular music radio in the UK. Everything is changing so quickly, and that's having an impact on radio stations, the music they play, and the way we listen. Conventional network radio, as I worked on it, is under threat. More and more people choose to listen to what they want, when they want it, from downloads onto iPods, iPhones, iPads, via the satellite, over the internet, or even from the BBC's own iPlayer website. There, anyone can choose to replay their favourite programme. Entertainment on demand is the slogan, and that threatens to make the old-fashioned programme controller obsolete. New methods of delivery, like DAB, won't really provide the answer. It's not universally available, particularly in cars, and good old FM sets never seem to wear out. So unless these new digital stations offer exclusive entertainment, which is only available on DAB, there's little incentive to buy a new radio. With the Eurozone crisis, many broadcasters can't afford the capital costs of putting in DAB transmitters. Even the DAB system itself is under threat from a superior system called DAB+. And there seems little agreement across Europe as to which system will be universal. In the UK we have DAB, while in Germany it's DAB+, and many radios won't decode both. In any case, all the indications are that those who take up this new technology are men aged under 35 with large disposable incomes, not the mass audience. In terms of technology, then, I'm somewhat pessimistic about the future of conventional popular music radio as it has been for the last 50 years. In content, too, there's much about which to be concerned. While the BBC has soldiered on with its four original national networks, it has also added Radio 6 Music, Radio 5 Live, Radio 5 Live Sports Extra, Radio 4 Extra, the Asian Network, and Radio 1 Extra, as well as their English local radio stations and the national regions. But even in English local radio there's doom and gloom, because BBC local radio has to bear its share of budget cuts. Consequently, what was the last bastion of truly local radio will soon disappear, as these BBC local stations will carry common programming networked across all of them during the evenings. What a pity. The commercial radio sector too has merged and consolidated in an appalling manner. Under the old radio authority, no local area was allowed to operate more than one station with the same format of music. The result, as you drove up and down the country, was a real variation in local news and music. Ofcom, the body that controls broadcasting in the UK now, has relaxed the ownership and content rules, and what was once a chain of very individual local stations have now come under the corporate umbrellas of several large conglomerates, and business is their main raison d'etre. It's a money-making operation. Operating costs are pruned to the minimum, and instead of broadcasting locally to their communities with music of their choice, the stations are programmed remotely with playlists dictated by music research. Personally, I deplore this reliance on research to choose records. Whatever happened to the DJ or programmer with a good pair of ears? The person who couldn't wait to get into the studio so that he or she could share this great piece of music with the listeners? Sadly, it's all gone. Instead, we have universal, blandless FM. Not so much with DJs with individual character as automatons. Here is, that was, here's a jingle with the name of the station, and here's another commercial. How sad is that? Where are the opportunities for the next generation of Kenny Everetts, Roger Scott, Neil Fox, Steve Penk, or Chris Moyles? Can you name me one independent local radio DJ who is allowed to sound like an individual today? Looking at the latest app for listening to radio on tablet, the Radio Player, I found capital FM stations in Birmingham, Derbyshire, Edinburgh, Glasgow, Leicester, London, Manchester, Nottinghamshire, South Coast, South Wales, Teesside, Tyne and Wear, Yorkshire East and Yorkshire South. And that's just the output from one group. It's a huge money-making machine. There are 36 Heart stations, 8 Magics, and so it goes on with the following large media groups owning most of the independent radio stations in the UK: Bauer, Orion, GMG, Global and Absolute. though that last one, Absolute, has concentrated on spreading the DAB word, and they have 78% of their listeners tuning to them on DAB, compared to the industry average of 31%. There it is then, a rather depressing picture of radio today in the UK. Maybe there are a new generation of listeners who just haven't got the habit of radio. In my youth, we grew up listening to the wireless, but now there is so much more on offer. We see people everywhere walking around with their headsets on, so clearly plenty of people are still listening to something, but what? My guess is that a lot of the listening is to music that they've downloaded, so they're not dictated to by the radio station programmers with their research music. It could be argued that by this arrogant approach, the radio people have brought this lack of interest on themselves. So, in conclusion, perhaps I should just put my feet up, tune to Radio 4, and consider that I've now become one of those boring old farts deploring the fact that things just ain't what they used to be. Radio 1, The Inside Scene, was read by Johnny Beerling and was produced by John Evington. The additional voice was that of Susan Beerling.